What's going on, everybody? Tom here with Keto Lifestyle, and as the weather is cooling down and it is finally appropriate to be having anything pumpkin spice, I'm going to bring you guys a recipe for a keto pumpkin pie. That's right, your Thanksgiving does not have to be ruined. You can have pumpkin pie on keto. You just have to use my recipe. So I'm going to break this down into three parts. I've got the filling, the crust, and then the whipped cream. So feel free to jump around as you want, but let me show you how to make it.
All right, now that we are going on this recipe, the first thing we're going to do is make our crust. And the first ingredient going into that is 2 eggs. Now you'll see that I am throwing this in a food processor. If you don't have a food processor, you can use a blender, or you can absolutely mix it by hand if you have to. The butter step will change a little bit if you're mixing by hand. Next step is going to be 1 tablespoon of coconut oil. You can use pretty much any kind of oil you want for this, but I find that since we're going to be using coconut flour, coconut oil complements it nicely. To our eggs and oil, we're going to be adding 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Now I know there are people out there who always double their vanilla. Don't do it in this case because I've already done it for you. And to sweeten up our pie crust, we're going to be doing 1/4 cup of erythritol. Now it does work better with confectioner's erythritol, but since this is going into a food processor, I'm just going to use granulated because the blades of the processor are going to grind this up very finely anyway. Next up, we're going to put 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now it is time for the base of our crust, which is going to be coconut flour. And I'm going to be using 1 cup of that. Now I will get the question inevitably anytime I use any alternative flour. People ask, oh, can I use almond flour? Can I use coconut flour? You can use almond flour instead, but the ratios are going to change because coconut flour absorbs a lot of liquids. You are going to need more almond flour than coconut flour. That being said, for baking, I definitely prefer coconut flour as it gives a bit of a sweeter taste to it. As you can see, I have ran my food processor just a little bit to get it incorporated, and now I'm going to be adding 1 stick of cold butter in small chunks. I actually would recommend going smaller chunks than I am because I found out that at this quantity, it's a little bit hard for my food processor to handle. But chunk up your cold butter, throw it in there with your dough, and then we're going to pulse it on our food processor until it is well incorporated. Now the stopping point that you're looking for is that there are no large chunks of butter, so just keep pulsing your food processor until all the large chunks of butter are broken down into small chunks. Once they're broken down into those smaller chunks, I just kind of run it on high for a few seconds to make sure that everything is nicely ground up. Now it is time to put our crust into the pan, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to coat my pie pan with some coconut oil spray. Feel free to use any type of oil you want or even Pam if you've got it. We just need something to stop this from sticking. And it won't stick that much if you forget to, but it definitely helps them come out in clean chunks. Now I'm gonna take the dough and just lay it down in the pan and spread it evenly. And then I'm gonna use my fingers to cake it on the edges, kind of like you would with a graham cracker crust. The trick here is to get an even coating and go all the way up the edges. I am using a very shallow pie pan here, so my crust is going to be thicker. But if you have a taller pan, you will end up with a thinner crust. But still go all the way to the top because you will need that for a later step. Now it is time to make our filling. And no shock here, the first ingredient going into it is pumpkin. Now I buy the large can, so I'm going to have to measure this out, but you're going to need 14 ounces of pumpkin. The smaller cans usually come in at 14 to 15 ounces, so 1 small can will work just fine. Next up is going to be 1/2 cup of heavy whipping cream. Now in normal pumpkin pie, you would use sweetened condensed milk. We can't have that on keto. So the trick that I use is to take heavy cream and add beef gelatin to it. Now, beef gelatin does not taste like beef. It is just a way of thickening the cream to give us the same consistency as that sweetened condensed milk. Next up, we're going to be adding 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. The next spice going in is ground ginger. I apologize that the label is a little bit hard to read, but you're going to need 1 teaspoon of ground ginger. following our ground ginger is going to be 1 teaspoon of ground nutmeg. And lastly, to bring out and enhance our flavors a little bit, we're going to do 1 teaspoon of salt. To sweeten up our filling, we're going to start with 1/4 cup of erythritol. Now, we don't want to use too much because of the cooling effect of erythritol, so to solve that problem, we're going to add about 30 drops of liquid stevia. The combination of stevia and erythritol allows you to get a pretty sweet product without running into the negative effects of either one. With stevia, you can get a funny aftertaste. With erythritol, you get a much kind of minty cooling effect. So you want to use them both in moderation. So if you use the combination of them, you can sweeten it up without running into those nasty effects. At this point, I'm going to whisk the current ingredients in our filling together until it is nicely combined. This way, I can taste it and determine if I need to sweeten it a little more or add a little bit more spices. But once we add our eggs, we can no longer taste it due to a risk of salmonella. So I like to hold off the eggs until after I've tasted it and can confirm that I like the level of spice and sweetness. Now that it's mixed, I'm gonna grab my little tasting spoon and make sure that I like it. In this case, it was right on the money, so I'm gonna go ahead and add my 2 eggs to the filling mixture. Now we're just gonna whisk this until the eggs are combined nicely. You will notice that the filling becomes a lot shinier and a more of a gelatinous kind of texture. That's exactly what we're aiming for, because as this thickens up in the oven and those eggs cook, we're gonna get that nice kind of bouncy, spongy pie filling consistency that we're looking for. Once you are satisfied that your filling is mixed properly, we're gonna go ahead and pour it directly onto the pie crust. Now that all of your filling is in the pie crust, use a rubber spatula to go ahead and make it as level as possible. Any of those weird peaks will burn slightly, and you can avoid it by just smoothing it out. Then what I'm going to do is take my thumbs and push down on the pie crust to form a lip over the filling. This is why I had said earlier that you want to go to the very top of your pie pan with the crust, because of this step. This also will help it from burning on the very tips of the crust. And as another precaution to stop the crust from burning, I'm going to wrap the edge in aluminum foil. This kind of changes the way that the baking process takes place, and it'll stop it from overcooking. So just take tin foil, rip a sheet off that's large enough to cover the top and get to the actual crust itself, and fold it around the edge. There's no science here. You can actually cut the foil if you want to, but I don't mind just folding a little triangle shape in it. When you're ready to cook your pie, go ahead and preheat your oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. And now that my oven has come up to temperature, I'm just gonna slide my pie right into the oven, and then we're gonna set our timer for 12 minutes. The point of baking the pie at this 425 temperature for a little while is to allow our crust to get crispy. But once the timer goes off, we're actually not going to remove our pie from the oven at all. Instead, we're going to drop the temperature down to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. No need to pull the pie out and let it cool down, just drop it and leave the pie in there. At this point, we're going to set our timer for an additional 30 minutes. Now, the pie is likely not going to be done after 30 minutes, but we don't want to overcook it. So at 30 minutes, we're going to stick a knife in and check it. As you can see, I still have some pie filling on my knife, so I'm going to do it for another 5 minutes. And keep doing this until the knife comes out relatively clean. Once it's clean, go ahead and pull the pie out, and then remove the foil edges to reveal your beautiful crust. Since my pie has been cooling for a while, and I'm about ready to serve it, it is time to make the whipped cream. For this, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. This is totally optional. Some people like vanilla in the whipped cream, some do not. I'm choosing to just to give you the option. Then I'm going to put between 10 and 12 drops of liquid stevia. Do not overdo the stevia here, guys. I know it's tempting to make it as sweet as possible, but trust me, the aftertaste will kill you. Then we're going to add half a cup of heavy whipping cream. Now all you have to do is whip this thing until it turns into whipped cream. Of course, you can use an electronic mixer at this point, but I like the texture better when I do it by hand. And for those of you that don't believe that I whipped this whole thing by hand, I'll post the uncut footage after the video.
All right, everybody, now that you've seen how to make it, it is time for the taste test. Now, as you can see by looking at my pie here, I've already had a couple bites, so I can tell you already, it's good. But for the sake of the camera, let's give it a go. Now, here's my bite. Got a little bit of crust, pumpkin, and then some of that whipped cream we just made. Now, of all the recipes that I've come up with over the course of keto lifestyle, this is the one that I'm probably the most proud of because it tastes almost exactly like real pumpkin pie. The crust is perfect. It is buttery, it is flaky, it falls apart as soon as it touches your tongue. The filling tastes exactly like the non-keto pumpkin pie filling, and the whipped cream, come on guys, it's heavy cream and a sweetener. You can make it yourself. With that guys, I'm gonna close the video. If you liked the video, leave it a like. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below. And if you have not subscribed yet, do me a huge favor. Hit that subscribe button, show some love, and I'll bring more videos just like this to you later on. And finally, for those of you who didn't believe me about making the whipped cream by hand the whole way through, I'm gonna go and put that video now, so enjoy it. And those of you who aren't crazy, I'll see you in the next one. Oh, you're still here. Well, I appreciate the support and the fact that you have watched this video all the way through. And since I didn't really do anything crazy for hitting 5,000 subscribers, I want you, the first person to do this, to go ahead and put haha, I win in big letters down in the comment section. And I'm gonna mail you guys a keto brick. They're kind of hot right now. I have a few of them around the house. So I'll reach out to you once you leave that in the comment section and send you a free keto brick. So I do appreciate the support and you watching this all the way through, but time for me to go. So I'll see you next time.